So here you go. You want to make sure that you take each of your times, calculate your gravities, take the average of your gravities, and then make sure that you do an ER with the average. You'll also be doing a standard deviation for your own gravities. Disregard this step over here. You will, just like you did gravities and average gravity and then standard deviations and a relative error, you need to do that for all the rest of the data in your group. So what you're going to want to do is make a table on the front page of your lab after your procedure, right by your standard or right by your uncertainty. Make sure that you list your average gravity, relative error, and standard deviation. Then you're going to include the average gravity, relative error, and the standard deviation for the whole group. Put the Excel spreadsheet behind that, and then on the final page, you include whatever other things that you did. All right, don't forget on Excel to copy your formulae and paste them without the equal sign so that the formula, the equation is visible. All right, there you go.